Hello friends, welcome to WiFiStudy.com, one-stop destination for all competitive exams. Friends, today we present the current affairs of August 2nd week in English. You can take it as 7th to 16th of August. Okay, this is the second week of the August 2016. So we prepared this for you for your all competitive exams. This will be very helpful to you if you watch this video. Okay, so If you want to prepare by the application mode, so you can download WiFiStudy app from Google Play Store. This will be definitely help you to prepare in exams. Okay, and if you like this, please like this video, please subscribe us so that we can help you in your exam to give you more videos, more notes and other study materials. And if you have any queries or any doubts, so please email us at support@wifistudy.com. And friends, if you want to buy this current affair magazine of per month edition in a hard copy format, you can buy this hard copy format current affair magazine in just 90 rupees. You can see already there are thousand magazines are placed on order, and you can take it as January, Feb or March, April, May, June. You can take 3 month current affair magazine in just rupees 90 at your home. Okay, in a hard copy format if you want this. So let's start from the international section. Friends, firstly we'll go to the international section, then we'll go to the national section, then we'll go to the sports, trade, economy and etc. So let's see what happened across the globe in the second week of the August, that is the 7th to 16th August. So let's first go to the international section. This is the first question in the second week of the August that happened across the world. How many robots have danced together to set a world record in China? Okay, so this is the news in this frequently placed in the newspaper, that you need to take care of this, that there is a Guinness World Record made by the China in the last week, in the second week of the August. So how many robots have danced together to set a world record in China? Option A is 1002, B 1005, C 1007 and D 1009, and E none of these. So let's go to the news section. If we read the news, then we'll get the answer easily. Over 1000 dancing robots set Guinness Book of World Records in China. Okay, a new Guinness World Record for the most robots dancing simultaneously had been set in China, where 1007 robots screamed in a unison, nearly double the previous record. And the height of the robots are 43.8 centimeter tall. Okay, so this dancing robots are organized in a festival named Kyungdo Beer Festival. Okay, so you don't need to remember the name of the festival or the height of the robot. You just need to remember that there is a Guinness Book of World Record which is set by the China by dancing more than 1000 robots together. Okay, so this is only that you need to remember in this, that this is made by the China, that's it. You don't need to remember the exact number of the robots. Okay, it is more than 1000, it will be enough for you in exam. Okay, so let's go to the another question. World first pizza ATM was launched in which country? Okay, so you know that pizza and all these fast food are very very famous in the western part of the world. So world first pizza ATM was launched in which country? Okay, so options are A, China, USA, Japan, Singapore, any none of these. As I told you that pizza and all these fast food are very famous in the western part of the world, so you will need, you will easily get the answer. Okay, in all these options only the US is the western part of the world. So let's go to the news section. First ever pizza ATM opens in the US. Okay, you'll get the answer from this, US. Okay, so the answer is B, US. The first ever pizza ATM has been installed at the university campus of US by the French based company Paline, which developed the ATM. The pizza vending machine on the campus of the Xavier University in Ohio and who can hold 70 12 inch pizzas and dispense them fresh and hot in the just 3 minutes. Okay, so this is the news. So you need to remember this, that the first pizza ATM was launched in US. That's it. Third, what is India's ranking as a business destination? Very important news as far as Indian exam is concerned. What is India's ranking as a business destination? India improved its business as a ease of doing business ranking. Okay, so the options are 94, B 76, C 58, D 90, and E none of these. So India ranking as business destination improves. As I told you, India improves its ranking. This is a survey which is done by the Transparency International. Okay, Transparency International. It is an organization which basically measures the corruption perception index. It measures corruption. It is famous for making ranking according to the corruption perception index. Okay, so India now ranks 76 as compared to 94 position it held earlier. So India improved its ranking from 94 to 76. So B is the answer. As you know, 76 is our current ranking as a business destination. Okay. Fourth, who has topped Forbes list of 100 richest tech tycoons? Okay, tycoons. So who has topped Forbes list of 100 richest tech tycoons? So options A are Warren Buffett, B Jeff Bezos. Jeff Bezos belong to Amazon. Okay. C Bill Gates. As you know, Bill Gates is from Microsoft, and Aziz Premji, Wipro. Okay, and E none of these. So let's go to news section. Aziz Premji, Shiv Nadar in the Forbes list of 100 richest tech tycoons. Okay, so they are business persons which belong to the technology industry. So from the two from India are selected in the 100 richest tech tycoons. So Wipro chairperson Aziz Premji and HCL co-founder Shiv Nadar is belong to the HCL. Okay, Hindustan Computer Limited. Co-founder Shiv Nadar is the only 2 billionaires from India in the Forbes list of 100 richest people in technology. Okay, they belong to a technology field. While the 100 richest tech billionaire in the world has been topped by the Microsoft founder Bill Gates, with an estimated fortune of $78 billion. Okay, so answer is C, Bill Gates. As you know, he is the richest person. Okay, so he has topped the Forbes list. So next, what is the length of the proposed gas pipeline to connect India, Bangladesh and Myanmar? Okay, this is important news. Okay, India has made a gas pipeline to connect India, Bangladesh and Myanmar. Okay, our eastern part of the country, like three. Okay, so you will get a first question can be framed from this is that India, which countries is connected to the gas pipeline. Okay, so the options can be placed as India, Bhutan, Nepal, India, Bangladesh, Nepal, all these. So you need to remember that the India has proposed a gas pipeline to connect India, Bangladesh and Myanmar. Okay, and it is of how much length? Let's see. Option A is 6200 km, B 6500 km, C 6700 km, and D 6900 km, and E none of these. Okay, so let's go to the new section as 6900 km gas pipeline to connect Bangladesh, Myanmar and India. Okay, 69. So you get an answer from this 69. 6900 km gas pipeline connect to Bangladesh, Myanmar and India. You need to remember this too. The government has ambitious plan to lay 6900 km of gas pipeline linking Bangladesh, Myanmar and most northeastern states and West Bengal. Okay, so there are few companies, BPC, IOC, LPC, which are working in this project to connect all these three countries. Okay, so you need to remember that is countries, name of the countries and the 6900 km, the length of the pipeline. So now let's go to the national section. What happened in India in the second week of the August? Okay, previously we did international section and now we are heading towards national section. So Mission Bhagiratha is associated with option A, urbanization, B, drinking water, C, rural development and D, education. Look friends, in upcoming papers, like from the past 2 year paper, the different organizations like UPSC and SSC and all these are making effort to put the questions related to the national news. Okay, they are preparing questions of different plans, different operations which India is moving towards, and they are doing government, central government is doing in which industry as a part of their operation. So you need to remember the different name of the missions which are associated with which industry, which sector. Okay. So let's options, as I told you option before. So let's go to the news section. PM launches Mission Bhagiratha and lay foundation stone of key development projects in Telangana. Okay, so firstly you need to remember this is that it belongs to the Telangana. This project, the foundation stone is laid in Telangana. Okay, this is the first question which can be framed from this news. And second, let's go to the news section. The scheme has been launched by the state government with an objective to provide safe drinking water. Okay, look at this. The scheme has been launched by the state government with an objective to provide safe drinking water to all. So you'll get answer that B is the answer. Safe drinking. So Mission Bhagiratha is associated with the drinking water. Okay, it is not related to the urbanization, rural development and education. Okay, so you need to remember this. Two things. Mission Bhagiratha is related to the drinking water and it is started in Telangana region. Okay, Telangana state. Which state has launched Barista Bunkar Sahitya Yojana? Okay, so Barista Bunkar Sahayata Yojana. So Bunkar is a community which works on the wool and different textiles. Okay, and Sahayata Yojana. Sahayata means help. Okay, so which state has launched Barista Bunkar Sahayata Yojana? A. Tamil Nadu. B. Odisha. C. Jharkhand. D. Chhattisgarh. And E. Maharashtra. So let's go to the news section. Odisha government has launched a special assistance scheme for elderly weavers. Okay, elderly weavers. So Odisha government. Odisha is the answer of this question. And Odisha government has launched a special assistance scheme, Barista Bunkar Sahayata Yojana, for elderly weavers to mark the National Handlooms Day. Okay, National Handlooms Day. Okay. As I told you before also that on the previous section of our video that the national day which are celebrated or which are organized in the country are important, and the work on that day, what happened on that day, which project is launched is also very important. Okay, so in this year National Handloom Day, what happened? Barista Bunkar Sahayata Yojana is implemented in Odisha state. Okay, so you need to remember this. Irom Sharmila is social activities from which Indian state? Very important question. As far as our exam is concerned, I mean, like this type of questions are oftenly come in the state papers, state board papers. Okay, so you need to look first. The options are A. Kerala. B. Manipur. C. Meghalaya. D. Mizoram. And E. None of these. So Irom Sharmila and 16 year long fast. Okay, she and 16 year long fast. Okay, so Manipuri human rights activist. So she is from Manipur. Answer is B, Manipur. Her age is 44, has ended her 16 year long fast against armed forces special power act 1958. Okay, so you need to remember this also that she did her fast because to end the armed force special power act 1958. Okay, so by this act, police and the military get a special power, okay, in these states like Manipur and Jammu and Kashmir to tackle the separatists and the terrorists. Okay, so she want to end this law, this act there. So that's why she did 16 year long fast. Okay, and granted bail by an Imphal court on 10,000 personal bond. However, she can be examined in court again on August 23. Okay, so you need to remember this. Irom Sharmila is belong to the Manipur state, and she did fast because to end the armed forces special power act. Okay, known as the APSA, APAFSPA. Okay, next, which state launched Quit India 2 movement? Another important question from exam point of view. Which state has launched Quit India? Okay, Quit India movement on 9th August, as you know. Okay, movement. So A. Tamil Nadu. B. Rajasthan. C. Uttar Pradesh. D. Chhattisgarh. And E. Maharashtra. Okay, so let's go to the news section. Maharashtra government launches Quit India 2 movement to mark its 75th anniversary. Okay, so this is a movement launched by the Mahatma Gandhi to end the British Empire in India. Okay, so they mark 75th anniversary. So Maharashtra government launched this. So answer, then the answer is E, Maharashtra. Okay, launched Quit India 2 movement. To mark the 75th anniversary of the Quit India movement, Maharashtra government launched Quit India 2 from Swaraj to Suraj initiative. Okay, the name of the initiative is Swaraj to Suraj. The initiative would emphasize on freedom from the illiteracy, farmer suicide, wastage of water, addiction among youth and corruption. So all these are the curse of the society. So illiteracy and wastage of water, so they want to end this. So they implemented this initiative, Swaraj to Suraj initiative. Next, which country has helped India in building Kundakulam National Plant, nuclear plant? Very important question. This will definitely come in the exams. Okay, which country has helped India in building Kundakulam nuclear plant? A, France. B, USA. C, Sweden. D, Russia. E, none of these. So PM Modi, let's go to the news section first. PM Modi, Russian President Vladimir Putin jointly dedicated Kundakulam Nuclear Power Plant Unit 1 to the nation. So as you see from the news section that the Russian President Vladimir Putin, okay, and the PM Modi, they both jointly dedicated this plant to the nation. So Kundakulam Nuclear Plant is helped by the Russia. So the answer is D. The first unit of the Kundakulam is a place in Tamil Nadu. Okay, nuclear power plant is jointly dedicated to the national by the Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Jayalalitha, PM Narendra Modi and Russian President Vladimir Putin through video conferencing. Okay, through video conferencing they are connected to each other and they dedicated this plant to the nation. Okay. Next, Yaad Karo Kurbani celebration was launched from which state? Yaad Karo Kurbani celebration, another important from exam point of view. Okay, so Yaad Karo Kurbani celebration. Options are A, Punjab, then Gujarat, C, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, and E, none of these. So let's go to the news section. PM Modi launches Yaad Karo Kurbani celebration. PM Modi, Narendra Modi has launched Yaad Karo Kurbani, remember the sacrifice. Okay. Celebration at the birthplace of the freedom fighter Chandrasekhar Azad at the Alizapur, Madhya Pradesh. Okay, so Madhya Pradesh. So it is launched by the PM Modi in Madhya Pradesh. So the answer is D. The Yaad Karo Kurbani is a 15-day program aimed to commemorate the 75th anniversary of the Quit India movement and 70 years of independence. Okay, so this is launched by the PM Modi in Madhya Pradesh. Okay, at the birthplace of freedom fighter Chandrasekhar Azad at the Alizapur, Madhya Pradesh. Okay, so you only need to remember is the name of the state where it is launched. Jaitley launches, Arun Jaitley, our FM minister, finance minister, launches data bank portal of MSMEs. Okay, micro, small and medium enterprises. The name of the MSMEs is micro, small and medium enterprises. Jaitley launches data bank portal. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has launched a data bank portal of micro, small and medium enterprises in New Delhi. The portal aims to gather information about micro, small and medium enterprises. An online finance facilitation web portal was also launched to provide collective funding options for SMEs. Secretary in the MSMEs is K.K. Jala. So only to remember is, okay, so there is a bank portal launched for MSMEs. Okay, there is a data portal launched by FM minister for MSMEs. That's it. Who is the head of the CBDT committee to review media policy? Another question, who is the head of the CBDT committee? Okay, the CBDT is named, the full form CBDT is Central Board of Direct Taxes committee to review media policy. They made a policy to review media policy. Okay, so options are A, Anand Maheshwari, B, Gopal Mukherjee, C, Nikhil Sukula, D, Paradeep Jalan, and E, none of these. So let's go to the news section. As CBDT has constituted a new committee to review the existing media policy for communicating the activities of the board and the income tax department to the public. The 9-member committee will be headed by the Mr. Gopal Mukherjee. So the answer is B, Gopal Mukherjee. Okay, so this is another question which is not as far as my point of view, which is it is as important from the exam point of view, but you need to remember there is a committee made for the to review the media policy. Okay, media policy. Okay, so the head of that committee is Gopal Mukherjee. Bharat Parva has been inaugurated in which city? Bharat Parva has been inaugurated in which city? This is an important question. As the options are A, Mumbai, B, New Delhi, C, Chennai, D, Kolkata, E, none of these. So Bharat Parva inaugurated at the India Gate lawn by the Shri Manohar Parikar. Okay, Shri Manohar Parikar is the defense minister of our nation. So Manohar Parikar defense minister inaugurated the week long Bharat Parva organized by the government of India at the Lajpat lawns, India Gate, New Delhi. Okay, so the answer is B, India Gate, New Delhi. Bharat Parva has been inaugurated at New Delhi. Next, which state has recently inaugurated Seva Kendra? Which state has recently inaugurated Seva Kendra? Okay, so Seva Kendra is inaugurated in some state. So options are A, Gujarat, Assam, Rajasthan, Punjab. So news is Badal inaugurates first Seva Kendra in Punjab. Okay, let's go to the deep inside this news as for what Seva Kendra is made. Chief Minister Prakash Singh Badal has inaugurated city first Seva Kendra at Landewali, where people will be able to avail services under one roof. Okay, so they opened to provide services under one roof. Okay, Deputy CM Sukhbir Singh Badal has inaugurated Seva Kendra at other cities also like Mansa, Pathankot. Okay, so total of 2,000 Seva Kendra has been constructed at the cost of 500 crore. Okay, so they made a Seva Kendra to provide all the services under one roof, and it is implemented in which state? Punjab. So the answer is D, Punjab. Which has become the first state to ratify the Goods and Service Tax Constitution Amendment Bill? Very important question from exam point of view, that a GST bill is passed in the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, as you all know, and the state which first state to ratify the GST amendment bill, okay, in the Vidhan Sabha is A, Gujarat, B, Assam, C, Rajasthan, D, Punjab, and E, none of these. So you need to take care of that this is a state which is from the northern side of the northeast side from the India. Okay, and Assam became the first state to ratify GST. That's the news. Assam became the first state. So Assam has become the first state to ratify the GST amendment bill. The parliament had earlier cleared the bill to usher in a uniform tax regime throughout the country. Okay. So B is the answer. Assam is the answer. You need to remember this. Okay. Assam, very important question from exam point of view. This will definitely come in some exam. Recently, Smart Ganga City program has launched in how many cities? Another important question, this topic is very, very hotshot topic from the exam point of view, Ganga project. Okay, as from the past 2 years, NDA government has launched many schemes, many promises to clear the Ganga and the Yamuna, but the programs didn't implement it so successfully. So that's why this is in news, and you need to remember the name of the cities where this project is launched. So A is 7, B 8, C 10, D 13. Smart city program launches in 10 cities. This is the news. So answer is C, 10 cities. Union Minister M. Venkaiah Naidu and Water Resource Minister Uma Bhartia jointly launched Smart Ganga City program in 10 cities located through video conferencing. Okay. And the other 10 cities, and you know, you don't need to remember the name of the 10 cities. Okay. So I'm not telling you the name of the 10 cities. You only need to remember is that the Smart City Ganga project is launched in 10 cities. This is all from your exam. Okay. In which year first separate rail budget was presented? In which year first separate rail budget was presented? You need to remember this also, that this is belong to the rail budget, and it is in news, frequently in news. Okay. So options are 1921, 1924, 1931 and 1934. None of these. So railway budget set to be merged with the union budget from next fiscal. From the next fiscal, both budget, as you know that the, till now both budget are separately allocated. Okay, now from the next fiscal, next year, both are merged together, ending a 92 year old tradition which started during the colonial era in 1924. Railway budget will be merged with the general budget from 2017 and 2018 onwards. Okay, if the merger happens, the railway will get rid of the annual dividend that it had to pay for cross budgetary support from the government. Okay, so extra cost which is burdened by the railway will be eliminated if they do so. Okay, so it started in 1924. So the answer is B. You need to remember that the first separate rail budget was presented in 1924 in the British colonial era. India's first ever bio-CNG plant is inaugurated in Visakhapatnam. Very another important news, bio-CNG plant. Okay, options are A, Pune, Dibrugarh, Allahabad, New Delhi, none of these. So news is first India bio-CNG plant inaugurated in Pune. So answer is Pune. A is the answer. Pune is the first city where bio-CNG, compressed natural gas, CNG, compressed natural gas. Okay, so it is inaugurated. Now from the trade and banking section, let's go to the trade and banking section. What happened across the country and the entire world? What happened? Which company has acquired job portal Monster? Okay, very famous job portal Monster.com. As you see in your newspapers, in your television, it has a very flashing news and about the job portal. This is so a company has acquired job portal Monster. Which is that? A. Randstad, B. BlackBerry, C. Google, D. Indeed, and E. None of these. So job portal, let's go to news section. Job portal Monster sold for $429 million. Okay, this is an amount, $429 million, very vast amount, very big amount. Amsterdam based human resource consulting firm Randstad Holding has announced that it would acquire job portal Monster worldwide for $429 million in cash. Okay, so monster.com is sold and it is acquired by Randstad. A, answer is Randstad. It is a Amsterdam, Netherlands based human resource consulting firm. Okay, so you only need to remember the name of the company, Randstad. Okay, which Indian company has ranked 58 in the top 500 US brand survey? Another important news, as Indian company has made rank 58. Okay, in US brand survey. A, TCS, B, Wipro, C, Infosys, D, L&T, and E, Sun Pharma. So let's go to the news section. TCS. Okay, Tata Consultancy Services rank among top 100 US brand. So the answer is A. As you see, TCS is the company and it acquired 58 rank among the 500 brand in the US. Okay, it was ranked 57 in the last year and downgraded by a place this year. Okay, so you only need to remember is that TCS, the name of the company, which ranked 58 in US 500 US top brands. Which Indian Institute of Technology, IIT, has signed an MOU with the National Highway Authority of India, NHAI, for the research project in laboratory and the field investigation on planned cement concrete pavement for highways. Okay, so highways, like for civil engineering, IIT is collaborated with NHAI, National Highway Authority of India, for highway projects. Which IIT is that? IIT Roorkee, IIT Delhi, Kharagpur, Kanpur, none of these. So let's go to the news section. NHAI signed MOU with the IIT Kharagpur for research project. Okay, so answer is IIT Kharagpur. As you see in this part of the news, IIT Kharagpur. So answer is C. NHAI is signed MOU with the IIT Kharagpur for the research project on laboratory and the field investigation for highways. Okay, so this is the news. Which organization signed MOU with IRCTC for ready to eat food facility? Okay, this is another important news. As you see, as you read in the previous week of the August, as IRCTC, Indian Railway, okay, ready to eat food facility, they signed MOU with another company.
Options are A, ISRO, B, DABR, C, DRDO, and D, BARC, and E, none of these. Okay, so news is IRCTC signs MOU with DRDO to get ready to eat food straight out of pocket. Okay, so if you go to the go by the railways and you want to eat ready to eat food, you will order it first before going to the train, and they will provide you, DRD will provide you the food. Okay, so answer is C. Okay, so you need to remember that DRD prepared weapons for our nation, but now they are heading towards the food industry also. Okay, so this is the news, you need to remember this. What amount will be transferred by RBI as surplus to government? So this is the news which is not important from your exam point of view, as such type of questions are not come in the paper, the amount, exact amount. Okay, so as far as your current affairs action, I told you that 65,876 crore is provided by the RBI to surplus to government. Okay, so you don't need to remember the name of the amount and all these things. Let's go to another question. Recently, what amount of loan was sanctioned by NOBA to the Punjab government? As I told you before also, then the amount is not important from your exam point of view. Okay, so NABARD has provided a loan to the Punjab government for 26.06 crore. Flipkart now on Kotak Mahindra Bank mobile banking app. So this is important as in the bank exam, it can be asked that Kotak Mahindra Bank is associated with which e-commerce industry, e-commerce company. Okay, so Kotak Mahindra Bank has announced the availability of Flipkart mobile site in its mobile banking app to give the customer a secure in-app shopping environment. Okay, so Flipkart and Kotak Mahindra Bank are collaborating together. Which bank launched Project Ananya? Another important, which bank from the banking exams, it is important news, which bank has launched Project Ananya? Option A, Canara Bank, B, Syndicate Bank, C, UCO Bank, D, Andhra Bank. E, none of these. So let's do the news section as Syndicate Bank launches Project Ananya aimed at digital banking. Okay, so Syndicate Bank proposed a project name Ananya to focus on improved customer service and offering the latest in digital banking services. So it is for digital banking, not for the female clients or something like that. You need to remember that it aimed at digital marketing. Okay, so answer is B, Syndicate Bank. Which bank has joined hand with the Korea Development Bank for business opportunities? Another important news for your banking exam, like which bank has joined hand with the Korea Development Bank? Options are SBI, PNB, BOB, Bank of Baroda, and ICCI Bank. E, none of these. So SBI, news is SBI Korean Development Bank joined hand for business opportunities. So SBI is your answer. A is your answer. Okay, signed a MOU. They signed a MOU to enhance business synergies. Okay, so SBI, who is the SBI chairperson? As you all know, and you need to remember this, this is a very important, Anandrati Bhattacharya is the SBI chairperson right now. Okay, which bank has launched Simply Save SBI card with SBI? Another important news for your bank exam, and launched Simply Save SBI card with SBI. Okay, this is a scheme launched by the bank, and then the name of the bank is A, Nainital Bank, B, South India Bank, C, Karnataka Bank, D, Corporation Bank. E, none of these. So let's go to new section as South Indian Bank. Okay, SBI card to launch co-branded credit card. So Kochi based leading private sector lender South India Bank. South India Bank is belong to the Kochi. Okay, Kochi in Kerala. And SBI, one of the India's leading credit card issuers, announced the launch of co-branded credit cards for the customer of South India Bank. Okay, so answer is B, South India Bank. Save SBI card with SBI. Okay, South India Bank. Which bank has launched 99 mobile application? Okay, star 99 mobile application. Okay, So option A is United Bank of India, B Axis Bank, C Bank of India, D Union Bank of India, E none of these. Okay. So this is a program launched by, this is a mobile application launched by which bank? Okay, you need to remember these two. UBI launches USSD based mobile app for basic banking needs with NPCI. NPCI is the National Payment Corporation of India. Okay, it ties up with the Union Bank of India, UBI. So the answer is D. Union Bank of India, not United Bank of India. Okay. And this application can be downloaded in an Android smartphone from the Google Play Store. What is the new minimum contribution to National Pension Scheme? What is the new minimum? This is important. Okay, you need to remember the name of the amount in this part of the section. What is the new minimum contribution to National Pension Scheme? A 2000, B 1000, 5000, 6000 in E, none of these. As NPS, National Pension Scheme, PF, RDA, lowers minimum contribution to 1000 rupees per year. Okay, so minimum contribution to National Pension Scheme is 1000 rupees per year from this year. Okay. So, lower the minimum annual contribution to 1000 to keep the account active in order to encourage more people to join the National Pension Scheme. Okay, so they made a 1000 rupees minimum to encourage more people to join the National Pension Scheme. Okay, so option, so answer of this question is B, 1000. Which insurance company has been fined with rupees 35 lakh by IRDA recently? Okay, as I told you insurance company, so this is the insurance company which is fined by the IRDA. Okay, so you don't need to remember the name of the insurance company which is fined, as many company and bank are frequently fined by the organizations, are government organizations. So you don't need to remember it, by as I told you that, and for your knowledge I will tell you that it is the insurance company which is fined is Bharti AXA. Okay, so A is the answer. Bharti AXA is the insurance company which is fined with rupees 35 lakh. Now appointments. Let's go to the appointment section. Who has recently joined IDFC Bank Board? IDFC Bank Board. For your exam, for your banking exam, it's important. So Anand Sinha, Vinod Rai, Kunal Sinha, Shashikant Verma. Vinod Rai is the ex CAG head. Okay. Comptroller and Auditor General of India. So let's go to a new session. Former RBI Deputy Governor Anand Sinha joined IDFC Bank Board. So Anand Sinha is a Deputy Governor, former RBI Deputy Governor. He joined IDFC as a Bank Board member. Okay. Who has been appointed as a MD of State Bank of India? Another important news. Okay, from the appointment section, as MD of the State Bank of India, Ashok Kumar Garg, Raj Kumar, Raj Kamal Verma, C. Dinesh Kumar Khara, and D. Gopal Murli Bhagat. E. None of these. So, Dinesh Kumar Khara appointed Managing Director of State Bank of India. Okay. So, answer lies in the headline of this news only. Okay. So, Dinesh Kumar Khara is appointed as a Managing Director, MD of the State Bank of India. You need to remember this. Okay. Who has been appointed as a new chairperson of Central Silk Board? Central Silk Board. Okay. So J.B. Devgoda, B.N.S. Kariappa, C.K.M. Hanumantha Kariappa, and D.N.S. Basigoda, and E. None of these. So Mr. K.M. Hanumantha Kariappa, new chairperson of the Central Silk Board, assumed charges. Okay. So C is your answer. Okay, K.M. Hanumantha Kariappa is appointed as a new chairperson of Central Silk Board. Who has been reappointed as a CMD and CEO of Hero Motocorp? Important news. Okay, you need to remember the name. He is reappointed as a CMD and the CEO of the Hero Motocorp. A. Pavan Munjal, Sunil Munjal, Rakesh Munjal, Ashok Munjal, none of these. So let's go to a new section. You will get an answer from this section, as Pavan Munjal is reappointed as a CMD and CEO of Hero Motobar. Okay. For 5 years. For 5 years. Okay. So answer is Pawan Munjal, A. Who will be the head of the committee to review e-commerce rules? Okay. Another committee which is headed by some person to review the e-commerce rule. You need to remember, because this relate to the e-commerce news and it is very important in India right now to review the e-commerce rules and policies, because e-commerce business is growing day by day. You know that more than 1 billion phones are right now consuming in India. Okay, so e-commerce industry is growing and a committee is made to review the e-commerce rules. So head of the committee is A. Amitabh Kant, B. Arvind Pangaria, C. Madhukar Gupta, D. Ashok Mohanty. So news is government to set up committee to review e-commerce rules. Okay, so government has decided to set up a committee to look into all issues including foreign direct investment and e-commerce. Okay, and this committee is headed by the Niti Aayog CEO. Who is the Niti Aayog CEO? Mr. Amitabh Kant. So the answer is A. Amitabh Kant. Amitabh Kant is the head of the committee to review e-commerce rule. Who is the head of the committee for caste census? Another important question. Committee for caste census. A. Amitabh Kant, Arvind Pargaria, Madhukar Gupta, Ashok Mohanty. So an expert committee has been set up for the government to clarify and categorize the caste name mentioned in the social, economic and caste census. Okay. And this is headed by the Arvind Pangaria, vice chairperson of the Niti Aayog. Okay, chairperson is the Amitabh Kant and vice chairperson is the Arvind Pangaria. So answer is B. Who has been re-elected as the president of Asian Development Bank? Another important question. This should be remembered and you definitely get this question in your upcoming exam. Okay. So A. K.V. Kamath, B. Takehiko Nakayo, C. Jing Liquan, D. Akinwumi Adesina, E. None of these. So news is Takehiko Nakayo re-elected for second term as ADB chief, ADB president. Okay, Asian Development President. Okay. So B is your answer. Takehiko Nakayo is the answer. Who has been appointed as the Director Power of Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited? BHEL. Okay, BHEL BHEL. So appointed as a director. Who is the director of the BHEL? So A. Tarun Sarai, B. Ranjit Sharma, Akhil Joshi, Madan Sharma. So Akhil Joshi is appointed as a BHEL director. Okay, you'll get an answer from the news itself. Akhil Joshi. C is your answer. Okay. Who has been chosen as a brand ambassador for ITC healthcare brand Savlon? Savlon. Okay. Who is chosen as a brand ambassador for ITC healthcare Savlon? Option Sania Mirza, Deepika Palikar. Sania Mirza belong to her tennis. Deepika Palikar belong to the squash. Jwala Gupta also led to the badminton, and Saina Nehwal is also belong to the badminton, and E none of these. So Saina Nehwal is a brand ambassador of the ITC Savlon. So Saina Nehwal is chosen as a brand ambassador for ITC Savlon. Okay. To encourage parents, the campaign is to encourage parents to let go of their fear and encourage children to push their limit and maximize their potential to succeed in life. So answer is D. Saina Nehwal is the answer. Birendra Singh Yadav has been appointed as the next high commission to which country? Another important question. Okay. So Birendra Singh Yadav is appointed as the next high commission for which country? A. Cuba, Mexico, Ghana, Nigeria. So answer is Birendra Singh. He is a IFS officer of 1997 batch. Joint Secretary of the Minister is appointed as the new high commission to the Ghana, Republic of Ghana. So your answer is C, Ghana. Who is the head of National Committee on Trade Facilitation? Okay, head of the Committee on Trade Facilitation. This is not important from your exam point of view, as it is not been asked in, these types of questions will not be asked in the exams, but also I'll tell you for your knowledge that that Indian government has constituted a National Committee on Trade Facilitation to develop the Pan-India Road for Trade Facilitation. Okay, and will be added by the Pradeep Kumar. So your answer is D. Okay, but this is not important from your exam point of view. Now awards. Who is the first Indian artist to perform at the United Nations? This is another important question. You need to remember, this will definitely ask in the upcoming exam. A. M.S. Subha Lakshmi, B. A.R. Rahman, Bhimsen Joshi, Dilip Kumar. First Indian, important here. This is important news. First Indian artist to perform at the United Nations. Okay. Washington D.C. headquarter. So, renewed M.S. Subha Lakshmi, honored by the A.R. Rahman at UN on Independence Day. Okay. So, it is a, the so answer is A.R. Rahman, B. Renowned Carnatic musician, vocalist M.S. Subha Lakshmi was honored at the United Nations on 15 August 2016 and the performance is given by the A.R. Rahman. Okay. With this, Rahman became the second Indian artist after Subha Lakshmi to perform at the UN. She was the first musician ever to award the Bharat Ratna. Okay, so there are many questions that can be framed from this part of the story as Subha Lakshmi, first Indian artist is Subha Lakshmi. Okay. Okay, first Indian artist is Subha Lakshmi, which performed at the United Nations, and second is the A.R. Rahman. And Subha Lakshmi is the first musician to get the Bharat Ratna Award also. So, okay, so you need to remember all these things. Okay. Who has won Best Actor Award at the Indian Film Festival, Melbourne? This is not an important question from your exam point of view, that there are many Indian film festivals organized across the globe and Melbourne is one of the part of it. So, options, I'll tell you that Nawazuddin Siddiqui and Sonam Kapoor win top award at the IFF Melbourne. Okay, so your answer is Nawazuddin Siddiqui, B. Okay, the theme of this is Women Empowerment. Angry India God Says will bring the curtains down for the festival. Now sports. Gymnastic Deepak Karmakar became first Indian to qualify for gold finals. This is important news, as you all know that she made us proud, okay, by qualifying into the finals and became the first Indian gymnastic to create history by becoming first Indian gymnast to enter the Olympic final at the Rio Olympic. Okay, she performed Prodonova World. Okay, Prodonova. This is the style which is performed by the Deepa Karmakar, and it is very dangerous. Okay, which is did by the Deepa Karmakar to qualify for the finals, and she finished fourth in the finals. This is also important. Okay. Michael Phelps became the first swimmer to win four consecutive gold in same event. He became first to bag 21 gold in all four Olympics. 25 awards total, and the first person to win four consecutive gold in same event in 200 meter individual medley Olympic title. You need to remember that he banged in 200 meter individual medley from the four consecutive year. He win this award. Which player recently ended his entire retirement to play again for his country? Okay, recently a very famous football player announced his retirement, and after few months, again in the second week of the August, he ended his retirement plan, and again he will play for his country. And name of that sports person is Lionel Messi. This is not important from an exam point of view, that's why I am not giving you the options. Okay, so Lionel Messi announces to continue to play for Argentina. Which country has recently won its 1000 Olympic gold medal? Important from an exam point of view, definitely will come into the exam. So options are A, China, C, USA, Britain, Australia. So if you see the news, USA win 1000 Olympic gold medal. Okay. And they completed by winning women 4x100 meter medley relay team. So USA is the answer. Okay.
And they got their first medal in 1986 Athens Olympic. Which of the following has recently won Australian Open squash tournament? Important, as Indian won the Australian Open squash tournament, and options are PV Sindhu squash, as PV Sindhu cannot be the option, as you know that she belonged to the badminton. Okay, second Saina Nehwal, Jwala Gutta, and the Deepika Palikal. So Deepika Palikal won the Australian Open squash title by beating Meher Henry of Egypt. Okay. And she stands on 10th rank in the table, ranking table, and this is the 11th title, her 11th title. Okay. So Deepika Palikal is the answer of this. Now that Calico Paul died recently, he was chief minister of which state? Recently a former chief minister died. Okay. Calico Paul. So options are Meghalaya, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Manipur. So news is, former Arunachal Chief Minister Calico Paul was found dead in the house. He lived in a CM residence where he found hanging. He was the Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh. So the answer is Arunachal Pradesh, C. Okay. Surfer Bernard Fadley died recently. He was from which country? A very famous surfer. You can see in this image that very famous surfer Bernard recently died. He belongs to which country? And Australia. Okay. Australian surfing champion Bernard died recently. So your answer is C, Australia. TKV Desika died recently. Who is? Musician, writer, politician, yoga guru. Okay. So yoga guru TKV Dasikar passes away. Okay. So this is the news. So your answer is D, yoga guru TKV Dasikar passes away recently. Veteran Tamil writer producer Pancho Arunachalam has passed away. Okay, this is the news. A very famous veteran writer, Tamil writer. Okay, passes away. He belonged to the Tamil Nadu. Hanif Mohammed died recently. He was a cricketer from which country? Very famous cricketer. Okay, former cricketer Hanif Mohammed. You can see the photo of the Hanif Mohammed in this section, as he belonged to the Pakistan. And the important news is only this, that he belonged to the Pakistan. You don't need to remember the other things. Okay. He belonged to the Pakistan. B. Muktukar passes away. Who he was? Na Muktu Kumar passes away recently. Who he was? He is a singer, lyricist, journalist, politician. So you can see from the news section that famous lyricist, he is a writer, he is a lyricist, he writes songs, okay, passes away. So your answer is B, lyricist. Akshardham founder Pramukh Swami passes away. Another very famous person, Akshardham founder. Okay, you can be asked in the upcoming exam that Pramukh Swami belong to the which founder, which temple. Okay, so he is a founder of Akshardham temple. Okay, another name of Akshardham is Swami Narayan temple. Okay, so this is the news from the second week of the August, and hope you will like it and you will subscribe us. We can help you in exam by that. So thank you friends, and best of luck for your exams. Thank you.